Rebirth. Have not I commanded thee? Joshua, chapter 1, verse 9, the King James Bible. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, wheresoever thou goest. The kingdom promised is not an earthly one with material riches, but a heavenly reward for the fields ploughed and the seeds planted. Blessed are those that keep their faith and lose not their hope. God's tasks will separate men. And for the sake of the Son of Man, you shall be spat upon and reproached. But in time you will rejoice, for you will behold, as the prophets did, a vision like no other. Yet remember, broad is the path, but narrow is the way. Humble yourselves before a living God, one whose very breath is life and inspiration, one whose light is cast equally on all. Seek truth, for the truth is but one, and the lies are many. Seek the face of God, and banish the darkness and clouds of wicked ways and storms of conflict. You have the power to allow yourself to be healed and to allow your sins to be forgiven. He alone has the grace in return to heal lands and bring judgment upon those who do wrong. God always accomplishes his will. His words, if spoken freely and often, will resonate within our hearts. They will challenge and cause change. In God's name, you must seek out those who suffer for righteous sake, and you will help them to stand and understand. Your hands may not be your own. Your actions are simply a result of the thinking that makes it so. Your fate and salvation rests with God and the grace of his decisions. Duty comes before reward. Nothing that is not may be found in God's kingdom. And so, many will claim service for God. Many will dress in costumes and perform rituals and be no closer to heaven than the sinners beside them. For men are walls between men. God may be worshipped in a barn more righteously than in any temple. Men of God have discernment and understand the nuances of liberties. It matters little who the author of the evil deed is, only that the evil deed has been done. Men easily make princes of devils. Freedom, as with salvation, is not granted by governments. It is ordained by God. Submission to the unrighteous rules or tyrannies of man is disobedience to the orders of God. Western civilization is bonded by the blood shed by Christ on the cross. We do well when we remember that no other path exists but through Christ. The truth of this sets you free. The light brings you heat, and with this comes love. pray for each soul, lest a thousand years of courage may disappear overnight. God is more than just an idea. To follow is a way of life. It is a manner of thinking, a discipline. For ideas give birth to words, and words give birth to actions, and actions give birth to reaction. You will only ever find what you are looking for. Therefore, you must believe that it exists before you can see it. The will to win always predates the victory. The odds matter little if the angels sent to protect us are innumerable. Yet still, the blind lead the blind, while the deaf listen to the deaf. Man's salvations are temporal. Man's gifts are clumsy and untimely. Man's faith is misplaced and misguided. Man's pains are insufferable without a grace and a conviction that there is more that we can never know, that there is more than we can comprehend, that there are hidden hands and great works to be done. The courage and convictions of one may rise above the fear of many. Never surrender an opportunity to glorify God, as he makes history from the sacrifices of the faithful. Doing evil evokes the wrath of God. It brings rain in floods and torrents. There is a universal justice that offers no reward in this life. Nothing that is so is not meant to be as nothing that was may be undone. Tread carefully in angry territory, lest the waters boil and the rocks you hold burn your hands. Surround yourself not with filth, but with cleanliness. Do good and have faith, yet tremble at God's expectations, for you have more to offer and much to give. Praise the Lord, for with gratitude we live in eternal debt, and out of a heart of sorrow and a grief are many things lost. And with fear are many things that should not be. The magnificent crumbles as we lose the faith of God in our lives. All true glories are as a result of a prosperity found in the abundance of God's willingness to love. God mends every flaw. God paves a path that requires both grace and courage. God places liberty before lives, as such account is necessary for evil to be vanquished and salvation to be realized. Selfishness through desire is the rejection of many other available destinies. You may never know what you have missed living a life void of truthful acts. All free will is granted by a God who is merciful and enacts a righteous fate. Forget not who you are. The world is a place of endless possibility and mundane thinking. The lions have easy pickings from herds of the unaware who may be corralled into panic or despair. It is wise to turn to accept the guidance of God. Wisdom is granted through faith. Understanding is granted through courage. Knowledge is granted through patience. The wise protect the innocent. The wise tend the fields. The wise care for the sick. The wise love the lost so that they may feel found. Common man will follow the words of men, while wise men seek the guidance of God. Great men are always students of the ways of the world. The wise encourage the learner and honor the teacher. Education remains the sole responsibility of the children of God. There is a natural law given. To each man shall be given a body and a mind and a skill. To each man belongs this and no more and no less. The faithless seek to acquire rather than to know. Your speech is your right to intellectual self-defense. Those who meddle with the laws of nature do so only to avoid personal responsibility. Focus on yourself to understand but not to judge. We all have a history. We know what we need to do. In all you do, be respectful, polite, honest, and hardworking. Fear no man more than you fear God, and you shall have a hedge of protection higher than any wall and sharper than any sword. Men should fight the good fight, while women should bring reason and heal the wounds. Children should pray regularly, feel loved often, and be given encouragement. Children should be allowed to lead their own lives, lest they learn only to make the same mistakes as all those who came before them. Adults make the mistakes that they should not, while children correct their errors as they encounter their problems. Adults are too often set in their ways. Yet there remains another path to break the chains. Parents too often display a lack of trust in their own children, which is just the shortfall from their own inabilities within themselves. God knows you. God knows you are not perfect. God knows that you suffer. God knows the struggles you face. God realizes who you may become. The gospel teaches us that all those who drink without faith will soon thirst again. Man's obsessions with his own micromanagement is man's own fear of himself. Fire consumes the world of those consumed by fire. Passion ignites as anger burns. We at all times must live aware of the consequences. Words will matter. The words of the Bible are more important than the words of the polite tacticians. Honesty is more important than popularity. Individuals matter more than crowds. To trust in Christ is to understand this and to seek forgiveness for all our sins. There is no drug that can replace love. Those honouring Christ will always encounter trials and tribulations. Even after thousands of years, life has changed very little. Still, many are lost that need to be found. Still, many are sinful that need to be saved. Still, many are voiceless that need to be heard. But one day, the meek shall inherit the earth. One day, we shall cast out all the demons for a time. There is a time to live and a time to love. There is a time to hurt and a time to heal. All we need has been granted to us by a gracious Lord and a heavenly Father who travels with us. Favor in Christ is fortune with God. Let us pray. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.